Hello and welcome to this quick fix drop stitches tutorial. When you have a drop stitch, do not panic. At first, you have to release tension of your knitting. When you're using weights, get them off, and when you're at around 1863, put something on under your knitting so it won't hang and it will not make your leather longer. Then your knitting is safe. You are going to look for a latch hook. A latch hook, you've got them in different sizes. They are used for making pillows and carpets. It's Smyrna, and they are used for fixing panties, no, nylons. This is a very small latch hook. We do not use them for this because it's too tiny. This is for the museum. This is over 50 years old. And you need your yarn needle and something pointy like, or something pointy like a knitting needle or a device like this, or this one. And you need two hands. Okay, let's start. At first I will explain. There are two different types of stitches to fix that are dropped. And there are some things you need to know. Your drop stitch need to be on the left of your work to fix. So when it's past the feeder and it's on the right, you have to knit another round till it comes here again. Yes, so to fix it, it has to be standing on the left of the feeder. Then you are going to find the stitch you need to fix. I'm going to stitch to fix this stitch, and you take your device, your pointy device, and you fix it. You secure it so it cannot drop further, because that will make no sense. And then you knit a little bit further, and I have to explain. Look, this stitch does not have a loop around those two little red pegs. Okay, that's okay. We are going to knit further because under the needle there is a stitch, and we have to release it because we are going to fix a drop stitch, and it will get released when it comes here. So I'm going to turn, and you have to watch carefully what's happening, because when you understand what's happening, fixing is a lot more easy. Look, now this needle is coming up, and at this point it releases the loop around the two little red pegs, and then you are going to take your latch hook. When you're on this point, you will notice that there is a loop around the stitch. We are going to release that loop. There is tension on the loop, and we first have to remove the tension, and we do that by picking up our yarn needle and simply slide it from under those peg left from the needle, and from under the one on the right, and that will release the tension, and then you can pick up that bar or that stitch from the needle. And now all the bars are released. This is my secured stitch. Then you are going to take your latch, and you are going to push it on the left of the needle underneath all those bars. And then we are going to take our secured stitch. And push it on the needle. And push it through until the latch is on the left of or on the right. And be sure that the loop of your stitch is behind the bar. Then keep it flat, take your first bar, push it over, pull the latch hook, it will close, grab the yarn of the bar, and then you can easily push it through the loop. Then you've knitted one stitch, push through that the stitch is behind the latch, push over the next bar, push, pull, see what happens, keep continuing, push through, make sure the loop is behind the latch, pick up the next bar. Oh, I'm watching through the camera, so sorry. Take it over, it's secured, pull through the loop, make sure you make the loop a little bit wide. Now keep continuing this until you have re-knit the last stitch. And then you can easily push it. Oh, of course I lose it. Over your needle. Make sure that the stitch is around those two little red bags. And then you can knit and your stitch is fixed. This is another one and this another one. So I keep continuing. But this is how you fix a drop stitch in the first way. So let's continue to the second ones. It's just a little slightly different. The next drop stitch we are going to fix is this one. First, I'm going to secure my drop stitch with my little pin. And now I'm going to tell what's difference. The big difference is that this stitch has a loop around the two red pins and a stitch under the needle. It really is not a big difference, but we are gonna knit again till the stitch comes up and drops. So watch this carefully. It's millimeter work. The stitch around the pegs is going to be knitted and the stitch under the needle will drop. And this is the point where we are going to stop. And this is exact the same thing for the rest as we did before. We are going to release the stitch from the needle by taking it off. That this happens doesn't matter. This is no problem. This will correct when knitted. So pick it off under both sides and pull the stitch from the needle. Take it from the needle. Now all stitches are released. Be sure that they really are dropped. So these are the bars, and this is my drop stitch. So now I'm going to grab my latch hook again. Oops, stay still. I'm going to put it in with the open side or closed, it doesn't matter, but put this side down so it won't hang in your knitting. Left from the hook towards underneath all those bars to watch your secured stitch, and then you pick it up with your hook. Be sure it slides behind the latch. Let's see if I can do this better. Be sure the latch is open, the stitch is behind the latch. Take the first bar, pull over, pull through, push through the stitches behind the latch, take the next bar, put it in the hook, pull, the latch will close, secure the yarn, pull through the loop. Be sure that you make the loops not too tight, and you will follow till you run out of bars. And the last one, pull through, and then you can put the stitch on your needle again. Make sure you push it down that everything is as it was. And then you are be sure that the yarn is around the two red pegs. This is not a problem, because when I knit further, this is the corrected stitch look. It's nicely, it looks very nice. And this just, this corrects itself. It's not a problem. And so you can knit after fixing your stitches. Of course, if you want to know how to avoid drop stitches, watch my video, How to Always Knit Perfect with Your Circular Knitting Machine. If you like the tutorial, give me a thumb up. If you want to see more of my tutorials and don't want to miss a thing about circular knitting machines, join my channel. I'd like to see you next time. Have a nice day. Thank you for watching.